Hey Nuggets! Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm doing the shading and highlight tutorial that all of you asked for. I'm sorry about my voice, because it's going to sound like shit at some point. My throat hurts and I keep coughing. So yeah, it started like 3 days ago, but I'll be fine. Okay, so I know that this is not a full body edit, but I honestly couldn't find like a decent one. But what's also good about this edit though, I'm gonna show you how to make a fur. Wait, how to edit a fur coat if you have the fur brushes for Procreate. If you don't, then just go on the website Gumroad, and it's going to be in the description. You can just type in fur brushes and it's right there. It's really easy, to be honest. And yeah, I'm gonna show you like everything you basically need to know when you're shading and when you're highlighting. This is going to be really easy. It's not going to be hard at all. I'm going to be doing this really quickly. I used to do this like really slow, because I would start off the neck and then work my way down. But ever since I've been watching like speed paints from other artists on IG, I would be like, nah, I'm going to follow what they do, because what I do is just taking way too long. So I need to do something new, and I have been, and it's working. So yeah, now I'm going to do the video. But first of all, to make my head fit, because you know when you resize stuff on Procreate, you lose the quality. So that's why I use Ibis Paint. So I go on Ibis Paint and get the same picture out, and then I'm going to bring in my avatar pic like that, and now I'm going to erase it, of course. So you want to act like you're doing a morph edit. Well, this is technically a morph edit. You're just doing the rest completely by yourself, without like painting it, reducing the opacity, and then like just using off what you see and repainting it that way. I really hope my voice is not annoying right now, because I really didn't want it to be noticeable, but it got worse overnight. And I really can't make it sound any better at some points. I'm always doing things really quick, because like I don't have patience. Sometimes I am gonna be slow, depending on what it is, but I'm not patient. So yeah. Okay, so when you've got your head done like that, you're going to try to fit it. I'm just making sure that it's nicely on there. Okay, I know right now my avatar looks weird, but I promise you it would look better. It's going to look better, especially after I do the hair and yeah, everything is put together. It's going to look better. So, and I just had to make sure by making it invisible and reappear again that it looks better. I'm going to save it. So you want to just go on the three dots and put save layer as transparent back PNG, because if you do it the other way, this picture is still going to be saved for some reason. So yeah, and then I'm going to go back to Procreate and add this in, and it fits the same way it was on. The thing is, when you use this, you can move it, but if you just change the size just any like a tiny bit, then that's when it's going to lose quality. I'm just making sure her head is just a tiny bit higher, that it still looks the same, but whatever. So when I do this, the next thing that I like to do is I'm going to make a new layer under the avatar's head and using black. I'm just going to use a sketching brush from what you already get from Procreate. I'm trying to keep using as much default brushes from Procreate as possible because not all of you would be able to get brushes because you have to pay for it. And by the way, I don't usually use this brush to trace stuff out. As you can see, it's trash. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to use it. Actually, never mind. I'm going to use one of the pens that I used to use. I don't use it anymore to, No, this one's better. I don't use it anymore to color in my avatar and stuff because I was watching so many tips on YouTube for Procreate, and one of them was using low opacity brushes, and I really see why, and it helps. And one of them is a painting brush that I'm going to use in this video. So all those tips I learned, I'm going to be putting it in this video, and you're going to know with me. All of you've literally been watching my videos and watching me improve at the same time, because if you scroll down, or if you're one of those people that saw my oldest videos from last year, I was not good at editing, but a lot of you thought I was, and wanted me to make a channel for my videos. I wanted to wait a bit till I was good, but I just gave my followers what they wanted, and there you go. Sometimes I always just want to delete it, but it helps some people, so it's fine. And you can see that little dot from what I forgot to take off. Oh yeah, and I know some of you would ask me where I get my pictures. I don't get it from like anywhere special. It's literally Pinterest. I just search up like IG girls or something, or if I have a specific someone in mind from IG, then I would say it and find the picture that I want to use. Because going on Google, Pinterest is so much better. Going on Google, first of all, the quality is not going to be that great. Second of all, you literally not finding anything you want to use. So Pinterest is just so much better. Sometimes you don't really find anything, but if a picture looks similar to what you want, then just look at that picture and then look down the similar searches for that picture, and you should find it. It's what I did when I was watching a YouTube video again on Procreate tips when you're doing cartoons and stuff, and telling me what pictures I could use. So I'm just like, I saw one that I liked, and I went on. It was just a zoomed in picture of Kim Kardashian, and it wasn't really like there after I searched it, so I just had to keep looking at whatever picture is there when I put it up and stuff. Okay, so after you've got it all traced out, you're going to, the next thing that I like to do is do the hair, and I make a new layer on top of the head using the same brush that I use in all my videos for hair tutorials. I'm just going to make a similar hairstyle to this one. Well, I kind of have to. It depends on the picture. Sometimes I don't really find myself needing to do this exact same hairstyle in the picture, and I'm like, I want to do my own instead. So I'm just gonna do like a simple straight hair because I can't be asked. I used to get asked how to do straight hair, and sometimes I'm just like, it's pretty simple though, but I do it anyway. So I think I did. No, I haven't, but I guess this is one. Okay, so I'm done with the hair, and what I did was I just went along with what I saw, and yeah, that's literally all I did. And then I made the hair fit into my Avi's head. So you don't need to like fully like go over everything you see on a picture. And this little like gap right here, what I'm doing to fix that is I just go on my Avi's head and do that. Oh, and another thing that you want to do with your Avi's head is go on sharpen, because you do lose quality when you save stuff on Ibis, and you just want to bring it back by doing that. And look, your Avi looks so much better, and there are some areas that I need to bring back, like her chin. So I use the smudging tool a lot, and you want to get used to that because it really does help. And I'm going to be using the smudging tool a lot in this video anyways. And then I'm just going to erase a little bit that I forgot to do anyway. So now I'm going to colour in my avatar, and we're going to make a new layer under the outline. Okay, so I'm going to be using the painting flat brush and put it all over her. So it's okay if it's like there, but if it bothers you, you can like remove it. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to anyways, because we're going to be using a clipping mask, and you want everything to like be within. Okay, now we're going to make a new layer, use multiply, and use a clipping mask so that we don't need to erase stuff outside that area I just explained. And we're going to be using the round brush. So this is the brush I use mostly. Oh, and most of the time, the skin on my avatar doesn't match my avatar's head when I start out, and I fix that right at the end when I'm actually finished with everything. So what I do is add multiply on the areas that needs to have it. So like here. So this is what I meant, like not doing it from one spot, because I used to like just shade in the neck first, and then it would take me kind of a while to finish before I move on. And if you're gonna get confused, you also wanna like, you wanna keep going back to the picture this way so you can see like all the areas that you still need to shade off, like definitely around here. So what I meant by another thing I'm gonna say, low opacity brushes. So like you see this brush, when you use low pressure, it looks like that. Then when you use more pressure, it goes darker. Or when you know do that, you create an ombre effect. So that brush is like so much more helpful and easy to blend. And also with blending, someone mentioned in my comments before to blend with low opacity, and I got that tip whilst I was watching tips on Procreate. That kind of sounded wrong. But yeah, I was doing that, and I tried it, and it was actually really helpful. So you want your opacity to just look like that when you're smudging. And I used a hard brush to have a smooth blend. And then areas I want detail on, I used the noise brush to smudge it out. Shading the neck is so, so easy. the neck will look better to me when I'm actually done with everything else. It's going to start looking together, I mean coming together in a bit. Got to keep blending, and also because we're not going to be just with one color. I'm gonna start using a different layer, and then remember to use clipping mask. I'm also going to move the outline just to make sure it's neat. And yeah, it looks pretty much neat. I just wanna add some more dark shade on the side. That's what I see in the picture. And I'm just going to smooth out the lines here. Okay, so it's fine at this point to use some darker shades, and I already have darker shades for my avatar skin tone. So how you want to achieve that is just eye drop this color and use it as your darker skin tone at this point. I'm going to be doing the sides and here and here. And then whilst you do this, you can kind of see why, oh my god, why am I using one color to shade this whole time? If I was using an iPad, I would tell you like what percent, obviously, but I'm not using an iPad. I'm getting an iPad soon. Okay, so it should start looking like so. And I'm gonna make the neck darker again. But right now I'm gonna start highlighting and I'm going to use, it's already eye dropped for me. So I dropped the lightest color of your skin tone, which is always mainly the forehead. And yeah, after you've done that, we're going to be highlighting. So I'm gonna start off here. And I'm just going to do the highlights where I see it on the picture. So it was on here and here and in the middle. So I'm going to start blending those areas. So you want to blend out from the edges. Thank you. for that area, I'm just going to select it and I'm going to use Gaussian blur. Alright, so I'm gonna start doing the fur coat. I'm gonna bring back the outline and I'm gonna choose what color I want. I guess I'm just gonna use purple like in the picture. So I'm using this fur and I usually like to use the curly one. I gotta fix my Avi's hair a bit so the coat doesn't look weird, but the next thing we're gonna do, use clipping mask and multiply again, and we're gonna use the curly texture and just go around the whole edit. And then the next thing I'm going to do, use curling clipping mask again, multiply, but we're going to eyedrop that darker color because we're going to go darker, and I'm going to go on back on the painting brush around the areas. I'm gonna do that last because they're wrinkles obviously, but I don't want them to smudge together at the same time, so I'm gonna just come back to it. Thank you. So I'm going to take the outline off again so I could see what I did and smooth out the lines. So I'm going to just keep doing that, and then I'm going to come back when I'm shading it even more, like the bigger areas. Okay, so I'm back and I'm going to be shading most of it, and this time we're going to be going darker. So I'm going to start off here, there, around here, here, there, and we're going to use Gaussian blur. And then I'm going to just smudge it out. And then I'm going to eye drop this color. And that's going to be a highlight. For areas like here. And so I told you it's pretty simple. And remember not to smudge it out like where it shouldn't be, then it's going to look weird. Okay, now I'm going to fix the hair. So back to black. And I'm going to use Liquify just to make this side look better. On the low, I'm actually just going to leave the hair the way it looks. And then I'm just going to get a background just to make sure that everything looks okay. Hey, everything looks fine. Okay, but under the fur layer, I'm going to make a new one. And we're going to make it darker. And I'm going to use that color. Back to the painting brush and using this. Make sure you're blending it out really nicely. And now I'm also just using a normal one again, clipping mask, and using a more lighter layer shade again, and going back on those same areas. And I'm going to be using the this noise brush. Going back on the airbrush and doing this area. I'm just going over it a few times so it looks lighter. And now I'm just going to I'm just gonna do it white. Well, not too white. I just want to add a little detail to the hair. It's the same detail length brush I use. And I just realized I didn't put any edges on. I'll do it in a sec. Oh, and for my backgrounds, because I know that some of you ask, I just go on Pinterest and I search up neon backgrounds. That's literally all I do. Oh my god, why did I do that? That shows why you do one side first. I'm low-key just being rushy for some reason. But some of you would look at this edit and be like, no, this isn't rushed. No, because if I just take my time with it for a second, this video would be way too long. I know I made a new layer. Oh, no, I didn't. And I'm just going to flip it. Put it together, make a new layer, and I know I would have made a new layer, but I just don't see the point why on like this part right now. Okay, now I'm gonna make a new layer. Just realized on the top, I just need to erase it. just when you're doing this, you're basically just following the flow of the hair. Okay, now I'm done. I'm just gonna put all the layers together and I'm going to fix the hair again with liquid. Back on that brush, and I need to do most hair strands. And I'm gonna use Kali too to do the strands better. Oh, and I'm gonna do the edges, just really simple. I'm gonna use a thick curly hair to fix the middle part a little bit. And there, you're done. And then I just got to edit my avatar, which is not a big deal. And yeah, so this is how you do a body and fur, and this is basically how I've been doing my edits for a while now. And yeah, so I'm also improving myself. I watch videos and tips and to make my edits look better by time. And I really don't do much with highlights. This is what I literally just do. And yeah, I hope that helped and you like this edit. I will get a full bodied edit next time. And for Ibis paint users, I'm going to do a updated one. But yeah, like I said, I just want to get some more Procreate tutorials out. And yeah, and I'll see you in my next video. Make sure you also like this video and also subscribe to my channel if you like me. And yeah, bye.